I'm Charlie from All About The Rock, and we're at Cambridge Rock Festival. Got some bands on the way. So, I'm Charlie from All About The Rock. I'm with Phil from Temperance Movement. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you. Charlie.
Explain to me, how did you guys originally form? For the people who don't know you guys, and you know, how do you get to where you are today?
Yes, well, we got together about 18 months ago. It started in London with Luke and Paul jamming on the guitars, and they called me to see if I would like to sing and write some songs with them. So we did, and we did that very quickly. Wrote, and then we started rehearsing with Damon and Nick on bass and drums, and we started working quite quickly. In between other work that we were doing, we started doing like demoing first, and then we went and did recording, and we played gigs in the Water Rats at London a lot, and the Borderline eventually, and we sold the Borderline out, but we weren't really together for very long. We sold the Borderline out, so it's quite a big deal for us. And we got in Classic Rock, and we got a little mention in there for Ones to Watch for the year. We got played on Planet Rock, which is amazing for us. That's the best thing that's happened for us, because that's where most of our audience have heard the song that they played. So, about 18 months ago that was, yeah.
Did you know everyone, were you all friends before you joined the band?
No, I mean, some of the guys knew each other better than others. Yeah. I didn't really know anybody apart from Luke, who I'd met very briefly before I left London.
Yeah.
I had met Damon before as well, like a few years before.
Yeah.
Nobody really knew each other.
Sorry, and who were your main influences? Who do you?
The Beatles, Sgt. Pepper, making a Sgt. Pepper, you know, really got me into music. Some of their other stuff like I'm Walrus and all that, and then the Stones, I got to Exile on Main Street just to check out what they were doing at the same time. I got into all sorts of things, Crosby, Stills and Nash, Gene Clark, The Birds, Tom Waits, anything like that, Neil Young. Faces was what when we were writing, I listened to a lot of Rod Stewart's Faces.
Is everyone in the band into the same kind of music, or do you have your different?
No, everybody's pretty much in the same thing, although Nick has never heard the Black Crowes.
Oh, really?
You know, we all love the Black Crowes, it's like a sort of favourite band. But Nick doesn't know them. It's great.
So you can take
everybody comes up to me and says, you guys are like the Black Crowes, he doesn't. Because no.
Who's he into then more?
Nick's into his kind of his rock. He likes his funk as well. It's Sly and the Family Stone, and you know, he likes some hardcore stuff. And so he's the funk element in the band. As a bass player.
You've got an album coming up. What should fans expect from this album?
It really just recorded versions of the set.
Yep.
You know. They're pretty good. The more I sing the songs, the more I realise I'm getting way off the melodies, and the songs were fine as they were. So I'd quite like to hear them again in their first state. But what to expect? Just a longer.
So the song that you played today on stage, everything's going to be in the album.
Yeah.
So fans who have seen you today at Cambridge Rock Festival will expect to see these songs that you played all today in the album.
Yeah.
And to the final.
Yeah.
Brilliant. And also, what do you guys get up to outside of the band? Just is there anybody that's considered a hobby?
Well, Nick Faith just went flying. Actually, he went on a little. Sort of stunt plane recently.
Oh, really?
He gets up with that kind of stunt a lot, which makes him sound as if he's in Pink Floyd or something. But that was something that he did recently. They all like creative stuff. Like, we go around to Luke's house and we get a 3-course meal every time. Just sit down for some snack. So yeah, I don't really get into much, to be honest. I'm not really that much into music.
Really? What do you tend to do outside of that?
No, I look after my little boy. I've got a little kid up at high school, and I've got a job, a coffee shop job that I work there. So I come down to do this, and go back home.
And you coming on to what we're doing?
Are we going to?
Yeah.
No.
Like this is the one not the kid.
We're doing every weekend for the next few weeks. We're doing a festival.
Yeah.
We've done a bit of touring just like just finished at the end of July there.
Yeah.
And then we'll go out touring again when the album comes out in the middle of September.
Yeah.
Which we'll go out again.
Are you expecting to go throughout the time?
Probably cover the same ground. We'll go to all the places in the UK. We'll go to the London. The Birminghams, the Manchesters, the Glasgows,
yeah.
You know, and then we're going to Europe as well,
yeah,
for a month, and then we're coming back to do another UK tour.
Yeah.
So it's going to take us from September right through to November, probably.
And today, I mean, I saw you had a really large crowd out there, and you've obviously got a very big following.
Well, I think they came in as we were playing, which
really?
Is good at a festival.
Yeah. They obviously saw you guys and thought,
you know,
really like this band. I mean, how do you define the crowd out there?
It's good. I mean, it's obviously different from playing in a small venue. You need to work hard and you don't always get anything back, but that's not to say that you're not feeling it. You kind of get you can hear them, you can't really hear the crowd, but you know you're in safe hands when it's called the Cambridge Rock Festival. You know, so there's no, you can't really go wrong. It's not like playing some uber cool club in the East End of London, like Hoxton Bar and Grill, and going up and, oh my god, between two stylistically untouchable bands, you know. We just love playing. We love playing in front of this kind of crowd because they just dig what we do, and like you say, just really good to talk to normal.
Are you
trying
to stay for the whole weekend? Just
not unfortunately. I have to go because we all have to go because we're playing another festival, the Line Up Festival tomorrow.
Yes,
in Derby.
That's what we're from Nottingham, so it's not too far.
Right, yes. Yeah. Well, Nottingham's a nice place. It's a good place for rock, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very good.
It's very
good.
Kind of rock.
Rock
up in
City.
Pendulum,
Sanitation.
You know,
very old pubs, but yeah.
Yeah, we were up
in Rockville
not so long ago.
Where were you playing?
Boys in Rockville.
Sanitation?
Bodega. Can I tell you something about that, mate?
Yeah.
That was the turning point of the first tour that we did.
Really?
Yeah. Because we were kind of aimlessly playing gigs up to that point, not really. And something happened in Nottingham. Because it was a tough crowd.
Yeah.
The minute you walked into Nottingham, it was like, can you help? It's quite a heavy atmosphere, right? Everybody was drinking in the afternoon. And we were like, shit, right? And so we had this place. It was pretty hot and sweaty. And it was a really great gig. And we did something for the first time there. Like, we did one of the songs, like, acoustically for the first time. And it was really a really good moment. And afterwards, everybody went nuts. And we thought, oh, this is great.
And finally, what... For the people who don't know you or people that do know you, could you say what you expect from you guys in the future? You know, from the album, it's an upcoming album.
I just think that we're in it because we like making music. Personally, I think it's all a bit fun. It's all quite ridiculous, you know, as well. And I think you can expect a band that are gonna play rock and roll, just, you know, for the sake of rock and roll. And we're not trying to do any new. Good groove and vibes and licks that have been used 100 million times before, and sort of melodies and singing and emotion that's been covered before. But just because that's where our heart and soul is, but we'll always have a good laugh. And if I'm not having a good laugh, so you just, you know, punch me in the arm or something. Because there's no reason not to have a good time. In the tent, basically.
One last thing I'd like to do is look to the camera and say, you're watching All About the Rock. Oh, yeah. We have 10 minutes to be watching All About the Rock TV.
We are the Temperance and Fun. You are watching All About the Rock TV.
Is that it?
Oh, that's awesome. How are you guys today? Good. 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 Good
Smoking mirrors. Everything always goes better.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like
perfect.
What should the fans of people who also don't know you, what should they expect from you in the future at all?
Outside dirty blue, the lights gather.
Well, I don't know, it's really unsettling.
Also ones like Pink Floyd, I think, are influenced brought up the stuff like ocean size, electronic stuff, trying to bring that in, but definitely successfully. We're always trying to grab new genres. £6, grab some sunglasses, and then when the EP comes out, you get down. So that's our main priority.
Try that again. If it's easier, one of you can just do it.
The sound started to change. We were going a little bit proggy. I'm really into like Queensryche, Dream Theater, Rush, Yes, you know, all those bands. And as well as, you know, Maiden, Priest, so prog metal. It's dear to my heart.
Is this the second festival you've played, or is it?
It's, we've done a couple of other things. We've done this festival with Rhythms of the World in Hitchin, which we've done, which is really cool. And a couple of other kind of more like local local kind of small cast. But in terms of albums, I think it's only this, but it's got rhythms every time. Bloodstock was good fun. It was good fun. It was 2010, I think that was. Which I kind of, I'm happy with how it went, but I'd love to go back. Like, if it was our first time playing now, with the current lineup of current songs, I think maybe we could do better. Very loosely. We've got, so we're here today, and then we've got a couple of things coming up right through till November. We're doing a gig for the Classic Rock Society, up in Rotherham. Deep Cycles, one of a band called Moon Safari, who I think are coming over from rather Swiss or Swedish. dreadful. Pay attention to geography, kids. But they're really cool. We're playing with them. We're doing a thing in London with a band called Spires from Manchester, and a band called Tempest Fusion from Hampshire. That's going to be really, I'm really looking forward to that. London gig, you know, prog metal bands up and coming. It's going to be just that. Then a couple of things in November. We're going to Holland for a couple of days, which is cool. And, a company called JBM Events, who are brilliant. They do stuff for David Wilson, Liz Space, Aiken, fans like that, and Pauliano as well, original names. So, and that's taking us right through to almost to Christmas, and we end on Danfest in Leicester, which is really cool. That's again like a proggy festival. I started there because we had a warm up on Thursday, and it wasn't hugely well attended, but it was a Thursday night, and because I'm from Bedford, we held it in Bedford, and they have like their own mini Edinburgh Fringe, Bedfringe. So I think maybe that ducks out. We lost a couple of people for that, but no, we had our album launch last year, and we did quite well. We did quite well in Bedford, and we're starting to get little pockets of following. Southampton, we do quite well. Which is where James is from and how we originally met.
So you're from different areas?
Oh yeah, we suffer from dispersed member syndrome. So we've got, I'm from Bedford, Alan Kirk is from Luton, Tom's from Essex, and James, that's why Southampton.
How did it all happen, like, when you practice? Because obviously Southampton from Bedford's a long way.
Yeah, it's a long way. What we do, because the three of us are quite close together, then Tom and James kind of travel in, and we try and meet up. At the moment, we're trying to keep it quite regular, because we're trying to get nice and tight, road ready.
Yeah.
But then, I think in writing it's a little bit, it's kind of more whoever can get there, really, just as long as some of us are meeting up and it can still kind of move things forward.
Yeah.
So it when we're not busy, it's a bit more flexible.
What shall we expect from you in the future? What are we looking forward to? Any more albums, any EPs,
shows?
All
of the above. what our kind of plan at the moment is, because we've been, all the stuff that's happening at the moment, like Cambridge right through to Danfest, it's all been stuff we've been working towards since late last year.
Yeah.
So it's all been like, all in the planning, and it's all been like, booked and waiting for it to happen. So what we're going to do is kind of just see, rather than making plans and trying to make ourselves really busy next year, we're going to take a back seat and just focus on writing. Loads of stuff. We've got an idea for the next album. And just, maybe 3 or 4 months and just see what, if anything, comes in the aftermath of today and the other gigs, with a view to recording, ideally late next year, realistically, whenever we can scrape the money together to go.
Fair enough, good luck with all that.
Oh, thank you.
One last thing I'd like to do is look to the camera, to the people watching, and say, I'm Matt from Hex, and you're watching About the Rock TV.
I'm Matt from Hex, and you're watching All About the Rock TV.